Our next generation communication team provisioned the ITS Communications Research and Innovation Network, CRAIN Lab, to serve as our testbed for 5G and eventually 6G technologies. ITS has long provided solid research and solutions in the areas of spectrum sharing, interference mitigation, and standards contributions for open and interoperable communication systems. Now, we're applying that expertise to the spectrum challenges faced by next-generation communication technologies. The initial focus of the CRAIN Lab is to deploy a cellular network that uses a traditional radio access network, RAN, system and test performance. Our next focus will be to deploy vendor interoperable 5G Open RAN, O-RAN, subsystems and compare O-RAN subsystem performance to traditional RAN performance. We will find out how easily O-RAN subsystems integrate into the network. This work is a presidential priority and aligns with existing work in several other line offices of NTIA and other government entities, including the FCC and Department of Defense. We began build out of the CRAIN Lab in 2021. In April of 2022, we completed acceptance testing for the lab's initial testbed capability. Now, our CRAIN Lab's 5G testbed is fully operational. The testbed is a commercial-grade 5G system consisting of a commercial non-standalone NSA core and a standalone SA core using typical commercially available user equipment, UE, or handsets in this case, to connect to the NSA and SA cores. The core in a non-standalone system connects to both 4G LTE eNode B and 5G new radio NR G-Node B systems. This allows handsets to operate in dual connectivity mode with a 4G eNode B operating as the anchor or primary site and a 5G G-Node B acting as a secondary site. Our standalone system includes one 4G LTE eNode B that transmits in band 66 at 20 MHz in 2x2 multiple input, multiple output, MIMO, and one 5G G-Node B that transmits in band N41 at 100 MHz in 2x2 MIMO. The core in a standalone system connects to only 5G. A standalone system does not allow handsets to operate in dual connectivity mode. For example, a handset configured for 4G only cannot connect to a 5G standalone system. Our standalone system includes two 5G G-Node B radio heads. One radio head transmits in band N41 at 20 MHz in 2x2 MIMO. The second radio head transmits in band N66 at 20 MHz in 2x2 MIMO. Throughput speed comes down to bandwidth. Wider RF bandwidth supports higher throughput, which translates to greater speed. For example, acceptance testing of our CRAIN Lab's non-standalone system showed 5G throughput close to 500 megabits per second. This throughput may increase with firewall setting optimization. Acceptance testing of our standalone system showed 5G throughput at 180 megabits per second. 5G throughput speed of our non-standalone system tested faster because that system's 5G radio head is configured to transmit at a bandwidth of 100 megahertz. While both 5G radio heads in our standalone system are configured to transmit at a bandwidth of just 20 megahertz. The standalone system may be configured for various bandwidths in the future to fully determine the effect of RF bandwidths on throughput. Our strategy has been to build out a commercial-grade baseline network using equipment from a traditional manufacturer. With our now complete initial deployment, we can conduct over-the-air testing in our shielded enclosure known as a screen room. The screen room keeps the test transmissions contained so that they don't disrupt cellular communications outside our lab. ITS plans to deploy a millimeter wave G-Node B at our outdoor advanced communications test site within the Table Mountain Radio Quiet Zone. A key goal for the CRAIN Lab is to acquire a variety of ORAN equipment to test ORAN integration, ORAN solution interoperability, and ORAN solution performance compared to traditional RAN. In addition, we plan to integrate our Software Bill of Materials, SBOM, work with Open RAN software-defined technology. This work is just one way that ITS is advancing innovation for the benefit of all stakeholders. We investigate our nation's most pressing telecommunications challenges through research that our employees are proud to deliver.